Hi dear friends, my name is Majid Garaya. I will guide you about soldering and I will teach you how to solder properly. In other words, I will guide you about some soldering tips. In electronics repairing, the easiest work to do is a solder a point. And as the size of the points decreases, it becomes more difficult to solder it. For example, when you work on TV or a CD player that have very big SMDs, it is very easy to solder the points. And when you work on very small electronics like mobile phone and computer SMDs, it is more difficult to solder the SMDs and points. Because as the sizes decreases, it is more and more difficult to solder the points. In this video, I am talking about mobile phone repairing soldering tips. The first advice for you is you have to use not only one soldering iron. One soldering iron is not enough for you. For example, I am using three different soldering irons for my work. Where it is proper, I use that type of the soldering iron. For example, you can see this is my very very big, you can see there is written 60 watt soldering iron. It have very very hot surface and very high temperature. I use it for where I think it is proper. And after this, I use this 30 watt soldering iron. You can see these are two soldering irons. I am not using just two soldering irons. I am using also another type of soldering iron. You can see this is Yihua soldering iron. You can see it have very thin nozzle like needle. I use this soldering iron to solder the very very thin points. That points I cannot solder with regular these two irons. I will use this Yihua soldering station. So dear friends, this soldering iron is very expensive and I have imported from China. But this soldering iron give me very very flexibility to do the things. For example, the very thin point in mobile phone is when you change the charging jack have very very thin points like human hair. But this Yihua soldering iron is very very good. I can solder points in a minute. So my first advice for you is, dear friends, don't use only one iron. Use low temperature, high temperature and very high temperature soldering irons for your work. And as the time pass, you have come to know where I have to use what iron. This is my first advice. And my second advice for you is always you have to neat and clean your soldering iron bit. Don't use with dirty soldering iron tip. Always clean it. I always use this paste to clean my bit. Whenever I use my soldering iron on points, first I have to put it on this every time. Whenever I use, if I use in a minute 5 times, I have put my solder iron 5 times in this paste. So this is very very cheap soldering paste. You have to you can purchase it from market. This is my second tip. Don't use direct your solder iron on points. First you have to always put on this paste. And my third tip is for you. You can see this is 0.7 mm solder. And you can see this is 0.4 mm solder. I am not always using the same type of the soldering wire. I am using two type of soldering wire, 0.7 mm and 0.4 mm. When I sold on big points, I always use 0.7 mm solder. And when I sold very thin points like charging port, charging jack or very very little SMDs, I always use 0.4 mm solder. This is my very very important tips for you. If you use same type of the solder for all your points, you will not able to do the things. Your points will be mixed in seconds. For example, you are changing the charging jack or charging port of mobile phone, and if you use this solder, whenever you touch the points, all the points will be mixed. There is no solution for that. You have to only one option. You have to remove this charging jack and put another one. So, dear friends, always use 0.4 mm solder. Don't use very fat solder. This is my third and last tip for you. Thank you very much for watching.